place in heaven.
Yeah. the praise team to come. Praise team to come. And we can start some praise and worship before we get ready for this service.
Heal my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord.
homegoing service. We bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Though the bottle may be hot, 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 and the conflict go.
I'm
Let me invite you all to stand as we prepare our hearts and our mind to get into this service today. Bless the name of the Lord. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Come on, let me hear you. Let me hear you. Life, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Whoever has faith in me shall have life, even though he die. And everyone who has life and has committed himself to me in faith shall not die forever. As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at the last he will stand upon the earth. After my awakening, he will raise me up, and in my body I shall see God. I myself shall see, and my eyes behold him, who is my friend and not a stranger. For none of us has life in himself, and none becomes his own master when he dies. For if we have life, we're alive in the Lord. And if we die, we die in the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's possession. Happy from now on are those who die in the Lord. So it is, says the Spirit, for they rest from their labor. We're here this morning to celebrate the life of Deacon Liebert Adiman, who came to this world and then departed April 9, 1963. On August 2nd, 2024, Everybody had gone to sleep. And he said, now is a good time to fly. If I had a wing like a dove, I would fly away. No more sickness, no more sorrow, no more pain, for the former things are passed away. Sleep well, my brother. We convey our deepest condolences to the family, to Reverend Adiman Nimoy, all the others. Be strong in the Lord. The hymn, An Unclouded Day. will say the opening prayer.
Bless the name of Jesus. Greetings to you, one and all. On behalf of the Hanover District of Churches, I once more express our condolences to the Adivan family. Bow your head to this prayer. Our Heavenly Father and our God, make and sustain of all things, King of all kings and Lord of all lords, the giver and sustainer of life. Father, we come before you one more time to honor you as God. Lord God, even in these troubled times, Father, we thank you, God Almighty, that we can gather here, though with mixed feelings this morning. Father, we honor your word today, Lord God, as you said for the saints, O God. To be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. And so we are happy to celebrate, Lord God, the homegoing of our dear brother this morning. Father, we thank you, God Almighty, for calling him out of a life of darkness into your marvelous light. Oh God, for using him in building your kingdom. And Lord God, now you have seen it fit to take him home. Lord God Almighty, this morning, we know many mourn. But we thank you, Lord God, that we don't have to mourn as those that have no hope. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Lord, I said, I thank you that we do not have to mourn as those that have no hope. Oh God, because your servants served you. Father, we have all come to celebrate today. I'm praying, Lord God Almighty, that you may open the eyes of all who are here. I'm praying in the name of Jesus Christ that you open your minds to the knowledge that you can call us home at any time. Father, by ourselves we are total failure. But we trust you, Lord God Almighty, to help us to be ready. Lord God, remember your church. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The body of Christ. Lord God, we undergo much troubles. But we look to you, Lord, for your help and your sustaining power. Remember every person, Lord God, who have not yet come into the knowledge of you. I pray that through this Thanksgiving service, Lord, everyone, Lord God Almighty, who have come that have not yet submitted themselves to you, will come to accept you as Lord and Master of their lives. Father, we ask your blessings upon today's service. Take full charge. Have your way in this place. In Jesus' mighty name.
I'm going home to Jesus in the twinkling of an eye. I've made my reservation to a mansion in the sky. Oh, I may not know. Today, we have a great turnout. Bless the name of the Lord. Nice to see Sister Eskew. So nice to see you. Bless the Lord. We are happy to see Reverend Malloy also. Bless the name of the Lord. He lost his wife and the funeral will be further down. Bless the name of the Lord. We're so happy to see you all. Reverend Buckner will come at this time and take us through our program. Reverend Buckner.
Good afternoon, everyone. Amen. I'm going to leave the choir for a little, right? Can we? We have our first lesson, Psalms 91 to 12, written by T. Adiman, daughter-in-law.
Father, and of the Son, and of the blessed Holy Ghost. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction, and sayest, Return, ye children of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight, are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as asleep. In the morning they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withereth. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thy wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are 80 years and 10, and if by reason of strength they be 80 years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow. For it is soon cut off, and we fly away. Who knoweth the power of thine anger? Even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. 12, and last. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. I'll repeat verse 12. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom.
Amen.
As the word is already blessed, we all say, Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Okay, so we'll take Blinning Choir, Blinning Church Choir, and after we'll take Reverend Forrester, family friend.
Hallelujah, somebody. Bless the name of Jesus. This song we are about to try to sing. The words, some of the words were said by Deacon Adiman before he passed on. He said, the best is yet to come. Bless the Lord. I'm happy today. As I travel through this land, I've been mighty blessed by God, and I'm holding to His arm. The journey's almost over, and the battle is nearly won, but I have a feeling in my heart. The best is yet to come.
Walk beside God. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Amen. Somebody praise the Lord again, man. Somebody praise the Lord. We have a selection by Sister C. Thompson, auntie-in-law, and also Z. Spence, sister-in-law. Sister C. Thompson, auntie-in-law.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone.
Hold on, I want to hold on, hold on to the old rock and roll. For
Oh, God.
the Lord, weeping endure for a night, but joy come in the morning, amen. Hold on, brothers and sisters, hold on, family, amen. Glory to God. We have affliction by the Bailey daughter, followed by In McLaren.
Good afternoon, everyone. Back when I was a child, before life removed all the innocence, my father would leave behind and dance with my mother and me. And I knew for sure I was loved. If I knew again, another chance, another waltz, another dance with him, I'd be a song that would never end. Oh, I love, love, love.
He was very quiet full of laughter, hard work, ye are a cheering spirit. Sense of humor, jovial, and very
from Galloway, CGMA, and also the second lesson, Revelation 21, 1 to 5, read by Leona Adiman Nice, Galloway.
Shall we praise the Lord? Lift up holy hands and praise God. Amen. Let me greet Bishop Campbell, the bishops, overseers and pastors, amen, and the officers. Very family, Pastor Adiman, friends of a family, community, people, accept greetings. I am here this afternoon because a friendship developed between Brother Adiman and myself, which if I should explain to you, it would take a long time. But I am glad that I met him. And the friendship that we had was a bond. Very, 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 very tight bond. He would always look out for me at functions, and he would always ask for me whether or not I am there. If he did not see me, he would not stop until he finds me. And he would always encourage me. But then I came to Blenheim at a rally that I chaired. When I heard of his death, I realized that God spared him for a reason, because we could have lost him a long time ago. But he gave him life so that he could come back and worship, amen, and socialize and really impart to some people, amen. And I am happy for that. And today I'm going to sing that song, which was a song that he testified about, amen. And if you know it, just help me to sing it. Far out on life's ocean, I drifted one day. The billows were rough time, I soon lost my way.
Pilot is.
For he promised to pilot my ship safely home. And how could I doubt him when his words are true? Oh, and from every storm there's a harbor for me. God is able. You have no need to worry. He's all right. He's resting. We all need to work to meet him. On that day, when the trump of God shall sound, hallelujah, and the dead in Christ shall rise, and the Bible said, those that are alive and remain shall be caught up. You will weep, but weep knowing that you have hope to meet him. God bless you. My prayers are with you.
From Revelation 21, reading from verse 1 through 5. And it reads, "Now I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away. Also, there was no more sea. Then I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned by her husband. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. 5 and last, then he who sat on the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said to me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. Here endeth a portion of God's holy word.
Amen.
Bless the Lord. Can you just stand for a change for a minute? Can you all stand for a change for a minute? Yes, man, I'm a little too tired, man. Can we just sing this song for a minute or two?
John saw the glory. John saw the light. Like a mighty angel moving on the land. Oh, John talked with Jesus. Moving on the
We're going to take condolences from the pastors. 2 minutes. Right, pastors? Bishop Nish.
Oh, somebody bless the name of the Lord. Hey, we can do better than that, man. Let us hear. Yeah, glory. Thank you, Jesus. There is a name. Praise God. That is above all other names. I've been looking at my program. I've seen Godfather. I've seen Prophet. I've seen Big Mac. I've seen Fighter. But there is a name. Hey, I want to extend quickly greetings. My 1 minute is gone. To the bereaved family, my good friend, Reverend Adaman. I met Deacon Adaman last year. Not meeting him, but that social rap at Bible Camp. And I just want to warn them. We want to warn them today. Yeah, glory. Hey, Abba. Somebody bless the name of the Lord. May I done. From family and friend. Somebody bless God, no man. Hey! But I want to challenge death this afternoon. That death has no victory over the church. Thank you, Jesus. Because this robe. This robe of flesh shall drop and rise to seize the everlasting crown. Yeah. Deacon Adaman, going shout and we going shout. While passing through the air. Farewell to her dear. God bless you, man.
Somebody bless the Lord. Somebody bless the Lord. Somebody bless the Lord. I'm going home with Jesus in the twinkling of an eye. I've made my reservation to the mansion in the sky. I may not know the moment. I may not know the day. Of Deacon Adaman, to some it's shocking, to some it's sudden, but it's a promise made to all of us, and it's important that we are ready. Amen, somebody. Amen. Praise God. I challenge us all today, be strengthened in the fact that this man knew God, so he died with the hope of eternal life. It's important for us to be ready to meet him one day. God bless you.
Lord,
I have a glimpse of a heaven in life. Oh, praise God, how mighty is God. All in all, put it in your shoulder.
same night. The master visit. For the other man. By the fear that would hear the master say unto him, choose now, shall praise the Lord. When he looked over that side, and he saw the angels. When he looked over this side, and he saw trouble, he saw pain, he saw agony. I could hear the young man said, Lord, take me as I am, my only plea. I have a plea.
Of the same. Bless the name of Jesus.
Today is a Thanksgiving service for Deacon Adiman. Bless the name of the Lord. We are rejoicing because heaven is rejoicing. Bless the name of Jesus. On behalf of the Silver Spring Church of God Mountain Assembly and myself, I want to bring condolences to Reverend Adiman and the rest of the family. Bless the name of the Lord. We are here to celebrate with you today. Bless the name of Jesus. He has lived his life, and now he has gone home, resting until that great day. Bless the name of the Lord, when the Lord shall put in his appearance. Bless the name of Jesus. I want to encourage you all today, family, Reverend Adiman. Be not dismayed. Hallelujah. One ear be tied. God will take care of you. God bless you all. Amen.
Give God a praise. The man of God is not here anymore. I get to understand that all when he lying on his bed and spiritual song sing, he say continuously. One time they ask me, no, I look where I come from. And I come here to tell somebody that his appointment soon come. A lot of us here have an appointment for tomorrow or Monday morning. Some of us have an appointment for go to embassy. Can I talk to somebody here? Half minute left. I have an appointment to see the doctor next week. So every minute I go and look at it. And if that appointment pass, I can make another one. But God tell us, you're not getting it. But the appointment from death is sure. Be very sure. Come on, church. Be very.
Passing. Amen.
His wife was a good person for the church. Coming here, before he even attended church, I could feel his hand. He's a loving person to me, he's a caring person. And as far as I'm concerned, even before he comes into the church, hallelujah, I love him.
Yes.
And he loves me.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He's missed by me. Today I'm not feeling that happy.
Yes.
But I have to thank God because God sees it fit to take him.
Yes.
And nobody cannot stop God.
No.
We can't turn back the hand of God. When God is ready for us, whether we're ready or not, hallelujah, we got to go.
Yes.
We got to go. Hallelujah. Thank God. My brother has turned his life to God. Today I'm rejoicing. Today I'm thankful to God because he turned his life to Almighty God. Whatever the cost may be, thank God for Calvary. Thank God for Brother Hardiman. Thank God for Sister Hardiman. His wife is a challenge to this church. His wife is a pilot. Hallelujah. And thank God, the moment I saw him join his wife, my heart rejoiced. Hallelujah. My heart gave thanks to God because I can say, not Mr. Hardiman, Brother Hardiman. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He was away, he was sick, but God raised him up. God allowed him to come back here to us. God allowed him to spend some time with us. Today I am here and I must be here. Hallelujah, I could not miss this hour. But I, hallelujah, give God thanks that he gave his life to God. And that is my only joy. That is my greatest joy.
Yes.
He did not just live and continue in sin, but he saw it fit to turn his life completely over to Almighty God. Hallelujah, and become a member, a stalwart member of this church. God saw it fit to call him home. Hallelujah. Thank God. Thank God for what I heard, for what I see. He was ready. Hallelujah. He was ready to go home. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. No greater love of no man than a man gave his life to Almighty God. Amen. Thank God for Calvary. Thank God for his son. Thank God for his blessing that he has poured out on Brother Hardiman's life. Amen. All I can do today is just reach out and touch the Lord. Reach out and touch the Lord as he passes. Use this moment, this hour, to say, yes, Lord. That they could say, at Brother Adaman's funeral, I have given my life to God because of the life he lived. Happy is the man, blessed is the man that put his trust in the Lord. God bless you.
Let us have a real time. Let us have a good day. Jesus.
God bless you, Pastor Watson.
Family. I haven't known Brother Adaman for no long period of time, but hearing all the good things about him, I am sure he had lived a good life. Praise God. And I encourage you to take comfort in Psalms 23. You know, though you walk through the valley of your sorrow, the comforting hands of Lord God will lead you and protect you. Take comfort in the Lord, because he promise that he will not leave us, nor will he forsake us. God bless you as we grieve with you.
Hello, my name is Joylyn Espute. I'm from Calvary Baptist Church in Morristown, New Jersey. I'm the missionary for Hanover. Yes, and I had the pleasure of taking care of Mr. Adaman for 6 months when he, you know, was recouping. And when I saw his numbers, like, was really high, I said, you have to go home to your wife to spend the last days with her. And we expected him to live 3 months, and he lived a year and 3 months. And I'm so glad I met him, because we have the same personality. He's stubborn, and I am stubborn, and I am Aries, and he is ears. Okay. But I love that man and I love Sister Ruby. Okay. Thank you.
For turning out. Thank you all for supporting us. We really needed that support. I thank you all so much. Okay? Handsome, you know, man.
Yes.
That's right. That's what we're talking about.
For you to climb, all you have to do is have some climbing faith. Oh yeah, no rivers too wide for you to make it crossed. All you have to do is believe it when you pray.
And every day will be bright as the sun. All of your fears, cast them on me. I just want you to see.
Why? will see the morning will come, and every day will be bright as the sun. All of your tears, cast them on me. I just want
to pay final farewell to my beloved Uncle Lee. It's really not the norm for me to speak before singing, as I really do not like public speaking, etc. Therefore, I would normally just sing and get it over with. However, today is different.
Yes.
Because of Uncle Lee.
That.
He was one of the most sincere, loving,
yes,
kind, and caring individual to have walked this planet Earth. You agree, right?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
From a child to an adult, I honestly cannot recall having a bad experience with Uncle Lee. Cannot recall. He loved and cared for my sisters and I as his very own. And by extension, our children just the same. And as such, we are grateful to have had
someone like Uncle Lee,
him, a part of our lives. And of course, we will forever cherish the memories of him.
Hallelujah.
Now, when Auntie Ruby asked if I was going to sing, I said, I don't think I can manage. But Auntie Ruby, me only know one song. What if somebody sing it? She said, sing it again.
Yes.
And guess what? The song was the first selection. So, this is my version.
Yes, girl. Yes, girl. Okay, girl, Sam.
Mountains
the Lord. We bless the Lord. We have 2 minutes condolences from Bishop Leslie and also Pastor Pierce. Bishop Leslie.
Yes, sir.
Brothers and sisters, a pleasant afternoon. Somebody shout hallelujah. No, I say shout hallelujah. Now that was a trial. Lift your hand up and shout hallelujah. Amen. Quickly, I have about 60 seconds leave out of it. Sister Adiman, let me tell you this, you're real friend of friend. I mean, you're a real friend. In a ministry, God bless you. To our worthy bishop and the rest of pastors and bishops, the Lord bless you. I want to greet you in the name of Jesus Christ. I want to tell you that I met Brother Adiman some time ago. And I want to tell you something, that the man, every time you see him, whether in a pain or not, him have a pleasant face. And we wouldn't have known pain, we didn't look like we in a sorrow. Amen of somebody. And that tells me the kind of person he was. But I must tell you even more, this sister Adiman keeps on requesting prayer. For many years, for this man. I've never seen a woman believe God for a man like this woman of God. And today she can rejoice in the Lord. But I've got to tell you that the best is yet to come. The Lord will say, bless you. And if I had time, woman of God, I would tell you that I am happy every day as I travel through this land. I am mighty blessed of God, and I'm holding to His hand. Church said the church is on us. Yes, sir. The battle is on this one. Church, I am a feeling in my heart. The best is yet. Long time said the best is yet. When I want to live it. Church said the first time. Yes, sir. Yeah!
river.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. I have been on this journey with Deacon Adiman. I remember Ruby calling me up here, said the man want to get married to me. That's where we started out. And I came one day and we had one of the most splendid occasions when we got Ruby and Lee Bert married. We went to the riverside not long thereafter for baptism. Then I was called again. The man decided to surrender himself to the Lord. So you need to come, there's baptism. And so I know that something unique was happening in the life of Ruby and Lee Bert. I know that God had a plan for their life, and I had to be a part of the party. We had fun, we had good times together. We appointed Lee Bert as a deacon of the church because after he surrendered himself and we baptized him, he had such great potential. And we said, this is the man we want in the house of God. And so we made him a deacon. There was never a place that I have gone since he surrendered himself that Ruby was there and Lee Bert was not there. Sometime he would say to me, Pastor, I'm sick, you know, but I cannot be there. I had to be there because I came in late. I came late. And I'm not wasting any time. Every opportunity that I get, I am going to be in the house of the Lord. He was a soldier. He had great potential. He loved the Lord. And he dedicated himself to serving God. I was traveling abroad and I couldn't leave without coming to see him. And I came to the house, walked straight in like I own part of the property. And saw him lying in the settee. And he said, Bishop, you're here. Yes, me say, I come to see you. And I brought something for the wife. And I said to him, I must continue to pray for you because God has something in store for you. We had a great chat and I prayed for him. Few days after, I got a call early in the morning. It's good that I keep my telephone on. About 3 o'clock in the morning, this woman will be calling me. And the moment you get a call at 3 o'clock in the morning, hey, if it's from your wife or your children or your friend, you know that something serious happened. And I got a call. I got a call in the morning. I want to share a quick word with you. Lee Bert was a different character. He came late. But the writer said, some come a morning. Penny a day, some come a evening, penny a day, some come a night, penny a day. Oh, bless the Lord, he was a good servant. It doesn't matter what time he came, he did a good job. Live your hand and praise God. He over. In 2 Timothy 4, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness. Lift your hand and worship the Lord, which the Lord, the righteous judge, hallelujah, shall give to me. Hey, and that day, and not me only, but unto all them that love his appearance. In our text today, Paul is sitting in a Roman prison, about to be killed for the cause of the gospel. Lift your hand and praise God. Paul did not think of himself as going to be executed. He said, what I am doing, I am doing it because I know that there's a reward for the people of God. Paul said, this life, I am giving it up. I'm giving it up. You can't take it from me. It doesn't matter what I have gone through. Paul said, I have been through shipwreck. I have been through trial. I have been through problem. I have been through heartache. And every time I know that my Redeemer is alive. Lift your hand and worship the Lord. Lift your hand and praise the Lord. Lift your hand and praise God. Paul said, I am now ready to be offered the time of my departure is at hand. Lift your hand and praise God. Our brother's departure came. It's good to be able to understand what David said in Psalm 23. He said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, if I power with me. Lift your hand and praise God. Is over. It is over. The battle is over. No more cancer. No more sickness. No more pain. No more struggle. Lord have mercy. Oh God, the writer said, the former things are passed away. Lord have mercy. Lift your hand and worship the Lord. Oh, lift your hand and praise God. No wonder Job said in Job 19 and verse 25, he said, I know that my Redeemer the one who bought me, the one who paid for me, the one who purchased me, is alive. Lord, I'm worried. I'm not worried about tomorrow. Tomorrow provide for itself because I have a relationship with the Lord. Oh, lift your hand and praise God. Hallelujah. After my skin has been destroyed, yet in my flesh, oh, lift your hand and praise God. I will see God. I myself shall see him with my own eyes. Brother Adiman has fought the good fight. Good fight. Good fight. Good fight. He laid everything down. He said, before the Lord comes and calls me, I am going to make sure that I'm ready. And so one day, when everybody thought that he would have stayed in that shop down there, oh Lord have mercy, this was where he would have made his money. This was where he would have provided for his family. One day he told me, he said, Bishop, I'm going to close the shop because I have a new relationship. God. Our brother had been bound by the anchors and rope of this world, the rope of sickness, pain, suffering, all had him tied up to this world. But I'm glad somebody needs to tell somebody beside them, you have been tied up with the things of this world, but I'm glad. Bless the name of the Lord. I'm glad. I'm glad that the battle is over. I'm glad that my pain is no more. I am glad that I've settled my old account. I am glad that I'm washed in the blood of the Lamb. I'm glad that I'm renewed. I am glad that I'm a new creature. All things. The battle is over. The battle is over. No longer is he crying. No longer. I believe after that cry, he looked at death as Christ did and declared, you have no power but that which was given unto you. Therefore I lay my life down. No longer will you taunt me, for I have found my victory. Oh, in Jesus, the battle is over. The victory has been won. I am a new creature. Hallelujah. I am ready to be with the Lord. Even in this moment or in the moment of grief, Uncle Lee, amen, we feel a great loss. Empty, Sister Ruby, stunned, dazed due to losing a part of someone that we love. But Jesus is still our hope as well and our salvation. You have lost a great part of you. Hallelujah. But you have a hope. Bless the name of the Lord. You have a hope in Jesus. Oh, lift your hand and worship the Lord. Somebody need to praise God. Oh, the writer said, it is a hard road to travel and a mighty long way to go. But Jesus, oh, lift your hand and praise God. Somebody need to say, but Jesus, when I'm troubled, I have Jesus. When I'm hurting, I have Jesus. Oh, lift your hand and worship the Lord. The Bible said they are standing at the top, a great cloud of witness. And somebody said, who are these witnesses? Who are they? Amen. Who are these who have come through great tribulation and have washed their robe? Somebody said, I saw Matthew, I saw Mark, I saw Luke, I saw John, I saw Paul, I saw Abraham. Who are these? Oh, bless the Lord, who have come through great. tribulation, and I've washed their robe in the blood of the Lamb. As he gets closer, as Uncle Lee gets closer, the captain will wave him on and say, come on, come on. There's a new life. There's a better life. All the roughness is over. All the pain is gone. All your trials are over. The writer said there'll be no more sickness, no more sorrow, no more pain. For the former things are passed away. Lift your hand and worship the Lord. Oh, lift your hand and worship the Lord. Oh, lift your hand and praise God. There's a great crowd that is cheering him on. As he bids fear away, fear away, fear away, fear away. There's a great crowd. And so I can hear somebody singing in the distance coming. Some glad morning, when this life is over, I'll fly away to an unchoiced lesson. Oh, I'll fly away. Is over. Somebody is looking for you to come over. Amen. And so we heard this singing. Soon and very soon, we're going to sing again. Oh, soon and we are going to sing again. Oh, soon. The battle is over. He can show no. He's on the deck. He's getting his praises on. There's something different. He can run. He can jump. He can shout. He can sing. And he can give God all the praise. All the praise. Down here he was limited because of illness. But I'm so glad the battle is over. He can shout. He can rejoice. He can praise God. And he looked around and he said, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. The battle is over. It's over. Stop with me, would you? Stop with me. Stop with me. Hallelujah. 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 I shall not die. But live and declare the word of the Lord. Amen. Like us to pray for you. Just lift your hand wherever you are. You'd like us to pray for you. Praise God. Hallelujah. I shall not die, but live and declare the word of the Lord. Amen. Reverend Campbell is going to pray.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your word. We thank you for the message. Today your people lifted their hands because they are in need of something. And so God, you promise, God, that if we only give you our heart, you will give us your Father's kingdom. Whatever the problems might be this afternoon, God, thou knowest everything. And so we ask that you work on their behalf. And I pray, God, that you will assign angels to minister to their hearts, so that those who have not yet accepted you, oh God, will surrender and come to worship you. We thank you for everything. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory, because you're God all by yourself. And for that we say, oh God, how grateful we are, because you love us in spite of our weaknesses. And so God, we thank you, God, for today. We thank you for the word that went forth one more time. Into your hands we commit those who raise their hands. Let your will be done in their lives. Let your will be done in their lives. Let your will be done in their lives. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. I was asked to continue the rest of the program. And let us continue our selections a Grimes, a family member, S. Whitmore, a family friend, and S. Whitmore, a family friend.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm going to try to sing a song, but I'm going to say a few words. On the behalf of Junior, Ayan, and myself, to God be the glory, great things He has done. To the family and friends, be strong. The Lord has called home a husband, a father, a brother, a cousin, and our friend. I would like to say more, but time is against me. Lee, aka Fighter Force, Godfather, and Gaddy. Sleep on and take your rest. We love you, but Jesus loves you best. May your soul find rest. I can hear a distant cry shouting out, the time is now.
Bless Whitmore.
Good afternoon, everyone. Just something quick before I start. I remember growing up, the young, the old, but especially the older folks, they know this man as Godfather. Yes, that's what they call him because he was the leader of the fighter force. And as kids growing up in the community, he's known to every single child, boy and girl, even to the older folks as well as Uncle Lee. My mother came to visit and he said to let me know that he loves me and he wants to see me. And I said, yeah, my mommy are going to visit. And Auntie Ruby, I didn't get a chance to visit. It's so sad that it comes down to this, that everybody has to gather under one roof to celebrate such a life. But this is my selection, my contribution to the family. God gives life, he takes it away. He is the part.
angels singing on our homecoming day, the silence will be broken. The silence will be broken. And the storm clouds roll away. I hear the saints of angels singing. I pray all of us will be ready for that day. We bless the Lord. We'll now have the remembrance. This will be given by S. Dias, T. Adiman, and D. Bailey.
Love could bring back Uncle Lee, he would be here right now with us. Uncle Lee, a lover, Uncle Lee loved his mother, wife, children, everyone in the community. A lot of people call him Godfather, Mr. Mark, and all those names, but I call him I call him Noah. Yes. Noah. His name now is Noah. Yeah. Back in the days, Uncle used to run a song called Fighter Force. Every big woman, little children, they would gather down in the crossroad where he would cook this soup, what them call coconut soup. I never eat it because I say I'm not going to eat that cow thing. You know what it is. But every night he would start off by singing this song, by playing this song. Black, 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 black roses in my garden. When Auntie Ruby hear that, you know, Auntie Ruby heart come down because you know how my cousin cute and all these young ladies around would come down and they would dance off them shoes here, and you know, so I have to play that song for Auntie Ruby. At all times he start off with that song, Black Black Roses. That's his Black Roses sitting right over there. You know, Uncle Lee is very, very charming, loving, kind, and caring. You know, Uncle Lee have 4 brothers. But he have 7 brothers because my mother have 3 sons. And every time the 7 of them would dress and go out, and he have 6 sisters, which she doesn't have by birth, but my sisters are his sisters because he called my mother Mama, and all of us call his mother my auntie. So we are one big family. He's my brother. I am the littlest out of all. So Uncle Lee is very kind and very caring. Did you know that the first drum set to this church was given by Uncle Lee? Yes. It was given by Uncle Lee because he's a musician. He loves music. Coming to church on Sundays, Uncle Lee would say, you know, I want to train these little boys to play the drum set. He have an electric guitar down there. He said, my son, and a keyboard. He said, my son, he wanted him to play the keyboard and teach you to play the drum set, and he wants somebody else to play the guitar. But, oh my God, it didn't come down to that. And Danica would be the singer. We're not talking about the bands yet because he said he had a song. And he said he's going to turn that song into a band. And Danica would be the singer on the band. The lead singer on the band. You know, on Sundays when we come to church, no one in the church could really sing. But Uncle Lee, when you hear his voice, mighty God, you hear a testimony about that. Tony would sit right up there and he would listen to Uncle Lee when Uncle Lee start out to sing, Mighty Man of War, Lion of Judah. Very, very talented in his singing. And him show off, you know, very, very show off. Hear him to me now. Auntie Kim, did you know that from I baptized in church, I don't stop from church one Sunday yet? Yeah? That was what he always said to me. So I would always sit down and laugh and said, I don't stop yet, Uncle Lee. But really and truly, I stop. But Uncle Lee never stop. Even when he is down, he would say to Auntie Ruby, tell me something, ma'am. If you can take me to doctor, and me, if you go to doctor in a day of pain, or me can go to church go serve God in this pain, I want to go to church. So they would buckle him up and take him right to church. Uncle Lee loved God, and that is what I love about him. He really, really loves God. Uncle Lee, when he was sick, I can remember him saying, Auntie Kim, me love Tiana, you know. Tiana coming like a daughter to me. Me really, really love Tiana. And I want to talk to Nemai for me. I wanted to talk to Nemai for me because Tiana is a professional nurse. Yes, Tiana would make some nice soup for him. One day, about the Wednesday before he passed off, I went down there and somebody else made some soup. And when I went down there, he said to me, Auntie Kim, I don't want this soup. Throw it away. Because when Tiana made the soup, it is so nice. So I take it back into the kitchen and I came out back and I said, what do you want? You want some ripe banana? I said, yes, give it to me. And I give him the ripe banana. And you know, Nicola had a see Auntie Ruby come back from work, and when she come back, she said, Auntie Kim, everything all right? And I said, yes. But she just sit down on the veranda out there. And while she was sitting down out there, I could see her crying. She was crying. And she said to me, Auntie Kim, you know what flashed across my face? I said, what? And she said, I see a white coffin with yellow. I see a yellow cloud. She was there crying. I didn't want to cry, so I just stepped right outside and I put my head in my lap and I started to cry silently because I don't want Uncle Lee to cry. I don't want him to see us breaking down. Because when people come by to look for me, you know, and they started to cry, I always say, I'm going to stop the crying. I don't want to come back and come back and break him down. I'm talking no English. That's what I always said. I'm going to stop from crying. I don't want nobody to come break him down. I'm going to pray for him. Give him strength. That is what he need. Uncle Lee always said, Tiana, you are the reader. Kim, you are the prayer. And he always name out in the church one who can do things. And he want us to keep it up. So have mercy, oh God. I am so happy that he gave his life to Jesus. I am so happy. Uncle Lee is a joker too. I'm going to give you a joke that he gave us one day. Uncle Lee said, there's a man in the community, we call him Roy. Some of the children then call him Uncle Roy. Roy would wear this bar chunk because he used to work in the sea. And the board, so he would wear this bar chunk and nothing more on his body. And he take up an iron fork and he went down into the sun hot and he start digging yam hole. And digging yam hole, Uncle Lee just come out the window and say, Lord, what a man, hard man. So in the community, you know, everybody call that man hard man. Everybody hard man. Uncle Lee loved to place nickname on people. He called one confident. trust had. He also said, there's a thief in the community, he said, when somebody was cutting the baby finger and said, we're not cutting baby finger with no nail clip, here Uncle Lee. Then tell me something, I wish part Gloria get nail clip from Ficot to Jaja. Toenail and fingernail. That's how Uncle Lee turned. He's very, very much jovial and jokified. With girls now, Uncle Lee have two boys, but he raised a lot of girls. Jareen, Samantha, Giselle, Danica, next daughter, his special daughter over here, his wife daughter over here. So, Uncle Lee loved children. When he went to America, everybody would glad to know that Uncle Lee coming back. And Kelly. Yes, Kelly. Because he always was a new girls. Anyway, when Uncle Lee go to America and come back, everybody happy. The rain is coming, baby. So, I'm going to cut right here, but everybody happy when Uncle Lee come back from America. Because he have a story to tell us about Bob and the farm and all of those people on the farm. But me know I hear the story, you know, me want the goodies. That is what I want, because when that barrel opened, I don't know how it serves so much people in the community. And to Ruby gone, so with bag. Uncle Lee gone, so with bag. Bag, 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 bag. That man is a kind, loving, and caring man. Thank you.
Good afternoon again, everyone. Please don't mind the PFA, just do my right bad and the right big. There? So, who would have known taking a pen to share your memories with someone that meant the world to you would be so hard? For me, just a few minutes ago, I mustered the strength to write this. My memories that I will forever cherish and continue to share. A lot can be said, and is already said, to prove how great of a man that he was. As for me, Daddy was, and still is, my hero, friend, father, and everything. Most of all, Daddy was my shield. Even when I'm wrong for Daddy, I'm always right. Even when I'm about to get a proper slap from Mommy, Daddy will always shield me. I can remember sometimes Mommy would tell me to do something, and when I don't move the same time, immediately she'll be planning how she's going to slap me. And then Daddy would go in the kitchen and come back and say, Mummy, the plan for lick you, you try your own. And then when Mummy start cussing out your hair, Daddy, Lord Ruby, man, I'm telling you to do something. Wait till he come, now he's who come. And then me and him will laugh about it and then we finish whatever she said I was supposed to do. And then you will hear, Mummy, Lee, are you make Danica dance up? You make Danny cannot listen to nobody. And you hear, Lord Ruby, man, don't know Danny not do it already. And then that was Daddy. Even when we're playing games, even when I'm losing, once we start balling, no Daddy gonna make me win. When Beryl came, he called me before we lost connection and he said, take care of yourself, you know. Cause when my seminar gonna be around long enough, we take care of you. And we leave you up and run with your girlfriend or stamp. So I laugh and he would say, Daddy, no bother with that man. And he would smile and say, take care of yourself. And for the year now and actually realize what he was actually saying wasn't about the previous experience that we had about the storm, but he was trying to tell me that he was leaving. I will forever love, cherish everything about Daddy. And he's the best father a girl could ever have. And there's nobody, or no man at all, other than God, of course, can take Daddy's spot in my heart. And I think everyone can say it was a privilege to know a great man like Daddy.
Amen.
Good evening, everyone. I won't be long. Even though I love to talk, I promise I won't be long. I am a stranger. You understand? A total stranger. And when me and Nemai started talking, one day Uncle Lee saw me and said, how are you doing to my son making a while left alone? He said, you tell me. Because I don't know what to do to him for him. No, no one left me. So I left him alone. Eh? But little did I know them, I was behind me. You understand? And as the years passed by, trust me, I never knew that Uncle Lee was such a nice person. Just to being a child of God when he accepted Christ, trust me, it's like it was a 360 turnaround. People, you have to experience it. You know what I talk about. Everybody will know me, knows me is not a big girl. Me, I go make dress. We go on Amazon, go buy shoes. My parents, them can't make me do that. Even though me forgive them for everything, them no worth certain things to me. And trust me, Uncle Lee and Auntie Ruby, them worth every bit. Every bit of it, man. Auntie Ruby, respect. Live up. You know some of your Uncle Lee have two little things at once. You get what I'm saying? You know, you're not part of that. That a few things. You understand? The little chops, chops them. And the little sneak in a thing in my mouth. Yeah, man, I don't know about it. Yeah, man, a few things that Zin. Respect and Ruby. My love goes out to you. My heart goes out to you, man. There's nothing that I would not do for you. Nothing. Just be strong. Zin. And we could just cook. You want some money? Never bang. See? Just let us live. Let us come together, man. And continue to do what Uncle Lee says. And the day that he died, the morning that he died, people of God, it was such a peaceful atmosphere. And up to now, it has been so peaceful. This man represents peace. Is it yellow and white? A happiness. He was a joyful man. No sadness, no day, no this. That's why I said to him at first when I read the scripture, are you happy to be here? Because I am happy to be here. I am thankful to God for the opportunity that he has given unto me. And the experience I will never forget. You see this eyeglass? Nothing to do my eye. But the first day I put it on, Uncle Lee said, yeah man, you look good. You understand? I will never stop wearing it. I will just strip up. What me say? All respect, man. This brother here deserves all respect. Everybody will come across to this man, man. Have something good to say. Live sweet and keep sweet. And let us do the thing. Because this man will leave a legacy for all of us. You understand? Let me live, man. And do the right thing.
This man must have been a godfather.
Yes.
Amen.
One godfather.
One godfather.
Amen.
Okay, we'll do the offertory hymn. Let me ask three ushers to come quickly so we can get through this, and then we have about four more to go before we recess this building. Come on, people, come on, people, come on, people. Come on, people! Let me ask the ushers to come, and we're going to give in aid of the church building fund. Some glad morning we shall see Jesus in the air, coming after you and me, joys ours to share. What rejoicing there will be when the saints shall rise, headed for the jubilee yonder in the sky. Some glad morning we shall see Jesus in the air, coming after you and me, joy is all to share. What rejoicing there will be when the saints shall rise. Happy morning when we
church.
Bless the name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise, we give you honor, we give you glory. We thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you for your many blessings that you have bestowed upon your people. And here we are in your presence. We thank you, Lord, that you have brought us here. Because we know, Lord, that one day you're coming back for a set of people who are called by your name. And this, our brother, has gone on before. We pray your blessing upon this offering today. We pray, God, that you will be done to the benefit of your work on earth as we give you thanks and we look to you for divine mercies. In Jesus' name, amen.
We bless the Lord. I'm moving as per instructions. Amen. The combined choir, just give a verse and on the chorus. The combined choir, a verse and the chorus. The other people doing selection. One verse and the chorus, then we take the eulogy.
Bless the Lord. For many a year, a traveler's pathway, sharing his joy, sorrow and pain. I've only a little longer in this dark valley to go.
And that I had to say goodbye to you so fast.
so numb I can't feel anymore. Praying you just walk right through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight.
Let me say a special good evening. A good name is better than precious assignment in the day of death and in the day of one birth. Ecclesiastes chapter 7 and verse 1 mean that when a one died, he must rejoice, but when a one born, he must cry. Mean that he die and out of his hand child, wicked word. But when a child born, he will be or she, and be a murderer. I was born as Cousins Cove, grew up in the district of Blenheim. Growing up, I know George Adam and Mrs. Lee's father. I usually dig him here for George. George died and Lee bird, Adam and take over the manual. I start work for Lee. One day, my working position as Lee's bush, he says to me that, Kaya, why the time is sick and we did everything done, and if a young man didn't want to walk. He said, well, Godfather, too. He says, I'm done. I run a year apart when I know young time, reaping time, I would put a ladder bag in my back pocket and say, I'm going to check Godfather. Perhaps I am to go. When I walk the dusty road of Blenheim and I reach a Sister Davis gate with his grace, I saw Liebert and the man coming from down the bush like some tired jackass with the bag on his head rocking up. And he said to me that, I want to breathe blow around down off a boat no man. He said, boy, either a good breeze or a bad breeze, I want to send you off to cook with two Johnny Kiffinier. He said, you want to send you off to cook with two Johnny Kiffinier, you don't want to know your man. Imagine you help me not going so hard, and you become come dig it. Man, I am the one who have for my wife, you know, for room, you know, love flower, you know. No room, no love flower, because you're out of order, you know. He said, just to make sure your man, I will hold up no hand, you know, you want, you know. And he would laugh and say, come man, I go. You know, and he would give me peace. And when he said, all right, I'm good, he said, no man, you're not good yet. And he shake up and he give me the rest, you know. Well, so sorry that he died and going to his grave. But the message we're going to preach. This evening, actually, you know, you see, when we come up in a while, we all of us think, say, look how we are living, what we do have today, you know. For a two purpose, we are on earth for, you know, the whole world, you know, give life to Jesus and we show salvation with him. I'm not a perfect man, you know, but last night I was dancing music, but dancing music. The psalmist gave us a music shall in heaven. And as long as you dance by yourself and know the type of music where you dance, and nothing. You know? Yeah. The serious thing by the face of the Ten Commandments of God right in the own hand and the relationship we have with him. At 6023, you know, Jesus will believe the whole of it. And he soon says it's done. All right, let me see if I can sing my song. I'm not going to sing. The golden morning is fast approaching. Jesus soon will come. Sing with me, church. To take his faithful and happy children to their promised home. Oh, we sing and gleam of the golden morning, bursting to the night of dawn.
Mr. Liebert Adiman was born on the 9th day of April 1963 to George and Lucian Adiman, the third of four children. His early childhood education started at Miss Florence Basic School. He then moved on to the Cocoon All Age School and then to the Dyer Seventh-day Adventist Private High School. Uncle Lee grew up to be a very independent young man. He liked farming and he liked to pick things. And so he gained the name Father Noah from his father. As he grew older, his farming skills expanded, and this he earned a spot on the overseas farm work program. As handsome as he was, he met and fell in love with his gem, Ruby Pierce, and they became a family. This matrimony produced one son, Nemoy. Lee also had another son, Tristan. Lee loved music, and so he started his sound system, Fighter Force. He was very respected by the community and by his peers. The community loved him. He was a general person. They gave him many names that through the years he got Prophet, Godfather, Fighter Force, Big Bang. And so he was very much respected. In 2019, leading into 2020, he started getting sick. And he could not walk for a while. But his faith never wavered. And so he promised God that if he ever walked again, he would serve God. And so be it. He walked again. Shortly after, he was baptized. He was a devoted Christian. And so he recovered and he gave his life to the Lord and was baptized. Prophet started working again, and this time he went again on the farmer program. While he was there, he got sick again. And for a while we couldn't see him, but we could always hear him. He called all the time. He wanted to check up on everyone. Even though he was sick, I remember when his sister died and he called home. And one of the things he wanted to do was to make sure that the Adiman family was well represented at the funeral. Sister Ruby, I remember you did very well. We cannot, Lord, thy purpose see, but all is well that which ends but thee. And so, on the 2nd of August, 2024, God saw him getting weary and bid him come to rest. He lived to mourn the lost, his wife, Ruby, two sons, four grandsons, three brothers, cousins, other relatives, and friends. Sleep on, Uncle Lee. Sleep and take your rest. Lay down your head upon thy Savior's breast. We love you, but Jesus loves you best. Until the morning, we will meet again. May his soul rest in peace.
Bless the Lord. We'll be having the prayer for the bereaved family. And Reverend Rahima Forrester will be praying for the bereaved family. See you as you come.
Remember me. Family member to be seated. And
those of us who are not family members to stand as we lift up the family in prayer at this time. Remember me. According to thy gracious word, in meek humility, this will I do, my dying Lord, I will remember thee. Eternal God and our Father, we come to you today on behalf of this family. We come, God, lifting them up before you, and you tell us in the word, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. We call on you, Jehovah, that you will comfort this family as they mourn. We ask, God, that you will strengthen their feeble knees. We ask, mighty God, that you will bind them together as cords that cannot be broken. We pray, mighty God, that you will give them the comfort that they need at this time to support them in all their needs. Most gracious Lord, we lift up before you, Sister Adiman. We ask, mighty God, that you will build a fence around her. We pray, mighty God, you will sustain her as you have done in the days past. We pray, God, that you will open the windows of heaven and pour out your blessing upon your servant. We pray, God, that you will help them to know that you are God and you are God all by yourself. We pray, God, that you will remember the family and that they will know that the family that prays together will stay together. Bind them with cords that cannot be broken. Hear the prayer that we have prayed in this place. And let the words of our mouth be the meditation of our hearts, that it will be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. And the people of God say,
just reach over and touch somebody beside you. Remember me. Hey. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Touch somebody else. Touch somebody else. That you're hugging today, you don't know what is going to happen later on. Hey, things and time changes. Hey, and so when you get an opportunity, use it to love somebody, to care for somebody. Remember me. Remember me. Oh Lord, remember me. And when those things test on, into the grave. Rain is still falling. Amen. We're going to go to the grave. Brother Lee, Uncle Lee, has finished the chorus. Amen. It's now time for us to lay this body down. Amen. The instructions are, as soon as we can go, the ministers will go first, the casket will come afterwards, and then all you wonderful people, the family and others, will come thereafter. Amen? We'll go to the grave and we'll commit this body to the ground. Stand, everybody. Stand. Let us sing the recessional hymn. I have a home prepared where the saints abide, just over in the glory land. And I long to be by my Savior's side, just over in the shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace, both now and forevermore. Amen. Peace and good afternoon. We just want to say a special thanks to those family members who flew in to be here. And we also want to thank Sister Espio for flying out of New Jersey to be here with us at this time. We just want to thank you so very much. God bless you. We're going to ask the ministers to move forward. We're going to ask the pallbearers to come. And we're going to be moving right on our next week.
There's a place in heaven.
Now my